Hi, this is Professor Ujjwal Kumar Chowdhury, the Pro Vice Chancellor and Dean of Media Faculty of Adamas University based out of Calcutta. I have been in media education for quite some time, from Symbiosis to Amity to Whistling Woods to Pearl and now here in Adamas. And all throughout these last 15-20 years, I have been seeing a growth in the spot or frequency of media conferences across India. And they have contributed immensely to the growth of the discipline, because communication and media education in India is relatively young. And particularly in the context of industry-driven media education, it's even younger, maybe not more than two decades. In this whole background, the emergence of DME colleges, this unique idea of ICAN, ICAN3 now coming, and the focus this time is on issues of community, agenda and news. This, which comes in March, and March 25 to 28, towards the end of March, in Noida, in DME campus, is a fabulous idea. They've already done ICAN earlier, and it's twice, and it had ISBN marked in the books publications, and more than 100 papers each time. This time also, they are setting their attention and their focus on agenda setting and community issues. It's very significant because over the period of time that we have been seeing, there is a decline of community issues in mainstream journalism. Yes, in alternate media, in social media, in alternate journalism, which focuses on certain groups, community issues do appear in quite frequency, but not so much in the context of mainstream journalism. So it's very important that this issue is taken up. Agenda setting, now they say that from gatekeeping to gate opening, the media's role is changing. From agenda setting to inviting agenda from the people, moving on to community journalism, moving on to citizen journalism, is a new paradigm coming up. And with the traditional funds for media organizations getting squeezed, crowdsourcing and alternative sources of funds will evolve, and that will require the media and communication domain to be more responsible and to be more responsive to community issues. Towards that goal, the DME's ICAN3 in March, I think, will be a path-breaking program. I'm looking forward to it as a part of the advisory board and also as someone who would be presenting my own views and papers there. I'm looking forward to it. I've encouraged my own department here in Adamas and also my friends and peers in various other universities and colleges to actively, wholeheartedly, enthusiastically participate in this ICAN3 of DME, headed by our very dear friend Dr. Ambarish Saxena and his wife Dr. Sushmita Bala. We are looking forward to this program ahead.